y'all. It's Mikey. Welcome back to another episode of the World's Prep. This is episode 2, sipping on orange sherbet, PR breaker. This is my go-to. This is my favorite flavor. And also, this is the only flavor that comes in the 45 serving tub. Yeah, 45 servings, so it lasts you a long time. We did about 2 scoops of this. So already about 100 milligrams of caffeine in, and then we're going another like 350-ish here. So we'll be caffeinated for a good deadlift session. But before we get to the deadlifts, before we go to the gym, I just wanted to talk to y'all real quick about my mental prep for big sessions. One thing I like to do, and this might seem like some corny self-help shit, but I do like to use some visualization. A lot of times, sometimes I'll be visualizing my top set for that session, what numbers I want to hit, how I want it to move, and I'll just kind of think through that before I go to the gym. Kind of just helps put me in a certain mindset. Another thing I visualize is whatever competition I have coming up. Usually, because I'm a good deadlifter and that's probably my best lift, I'm always thinking about pulling my third pull for the win, and then I kind of just work myself through the emotions that I'll feel if I hit that pull. And that's something that, like, especially going to Worlds, is something I don't even really have to try to do. It kind of just comes to me throughout the day. I'll think about my third pull. I'll think about holding on to my third pull and then securing a W, World Championship. And it just kind of takes me through. I feel the emotions that I think I will feel on the day, you know, when it happens. So that's one thing I like to do to get my mind right. Another thing I like to do, again, it even seems corny to me sometimes when I'm doing it, but I think it helps my mind put me in a certain mental state to turn it on when I need to turn it on. So I do have this mantra. It's just a quick and easy mantra, and I'll say it before big sets, and then it's almost like, you know, you listen to a certain song before all big sets, and so when you hear that song, your body just kind of knows to turn it on. It's kind of the same thing. I'll say this before big sets, and then so when I say it, my mind just kind of knows, like, all right, it's time to turn it on. So I'm not going to tell y'all what it is, but nah, I'll tell y'all. I say too big, too strong, too technical. Just those three things, and I'll just repeat that to myself. Too big, too strong, too technical. Too big, too strong, too technical. And then sometimes I'll do that on the way to the gym if I just feel like I'm not in it. And then some, again, like I said, I'll do it before big lifts. Sometimes it's hard for me, and I don't know if it's like this for anybody else, but when you've hit a certain weight so many times, sometimes it's hard for your mind to get up for it. Like, I've hit, 800 deadlift, like, a lot of times already, at least 765, like, a ton of times. Like, maybe, like, session to session, I'll hit it weekly. So the days where I'm not, like, in it mentally, and I'll load that weight up, and it just feels like another warm-up in my brain. But sometimes if you want your weights to move, you gotta turn it on. So I could do that two ways. I could either, sometimes I have to slap my weight on the bar and then my body knows, like, hey, this shit's real. Or the other way is I'll repeat this little mantra to myself, and then also, like I said, use some visualization. So anyways, just some little mental keys that I use. Again, I don't do this all the time. It's for big sessions, and it's when I get closer to big meets that I usually start doing stuff like this. So that's all I got for y'all right now. I'm gonna knock this pre out, head to the gym. I'll see y'all there.
Let's go. Come on, make up for that single. Make it. Watch your little explosion. Come on, Mikey.
Come on. Let's go.
Yo, dear Mikey,
from the bottom of our hearts, bro, you're a handsome guy, bro. But Clay's more handsome.
All right, what's up, y'all? Just got done with the deadlift session and the bench work. Was building up to my top single, and I felt my callus building up more than usual. And I think this is because I've been hitting like that one back down set with hook grip, so my calluses are have just been building up more. And so I kind of knew it was gonna tear, but I tried to pull the 771 anyways just to see if I could pull it. And then right off the ground, I felt it tear. So I ended up strapping for the top single. It still moved okay. And then I strapped for all the back down work. So I know I said in the grip video that I was going to hook grip at least one back down set, but from now on, I think just for my thumb health purposes, I'm gonna be strapping all the back downs and then just doing that long hold on all the top singles. But it hasn't given out one time this whole prep until today, and that was just because of the tear. So I'm not worried about it. I'm gonna keep doing my grip work after deadlifts, and I'm gonna keep doing the long holds on the top singles, and I think we're gonna be all right. But that's all I got for this video. I will be doing a Q&A at 500 subs. I think the last time I checked that was 495, so should be soon. So stay posted for the Q&A on Instagram, and then I'm gonna answer the questions here on a YouTube video, probably my next video. So yeah, that's all I got for today's video. I'll see you on the next one. I'm out.